Hey everyone, welcome back to another Musical Monday. It is actually the very, very last one of the school year, so we're doing something a little different, and I am super excited because we are going to be calling random people in my phone from school to see what their favorite song is and why. So let's just get right into it.
Hello.
What's your favorite song?
So that would be Black Eyed Peas. It would be Where's the Love, because it portrays a message that most people don't get.
Awesome, thank you.
Yeah.
What's your favorite song?
One of my favorites is definitely Counting Stars by OneRepublic.
Okay. Why?
That's a good question. I don't know, I guess I really like it's upbeat and I like the lyrics, and yeah, I guess that's just basically it.
Okay. Hey everyone.
Hi.
What's your favorite song and why?
I would have to say Moonlight Sonata by Beethoven, just because it shows a tremendous amount of emotion and you can really paint different images of the song.
What's your favorite song and why?
My favorite song is the song Perfect by Ed Sheeran, because I would hear it as a child and it just sounded like such a beautiful song.
What's your favorite song and why?
That's Solo Cup, because it's an upbeat and upbeat song, and I like country music.
You said it's called Red Shovel?
No, Red Shovel.
Play too much anymore? I really like Boyfriend by Dev Cameron, though. That's a new one that I really like, and you're listening to it now.
Hey everyone, welcome to this year's very last episode of Tip Tuesday. As you all know, seniors graduate tomorrow, so in honor of that, I've asked 8 seniors for any piece of advice they'd like to share. So, without further ado, let's begin. What's a piece of advice that has stuck with you?
Don't be afraid to try new things.
Do or do not, there is no try.
Don't avoid challenges, instead enjoy them.
And not to be lazy, work hard, and you will reap the benefits.
No matter what you're doing or who you're talking to, keep an open mind and try everything at least once. You never know what's going to come out of a new opportunity, because everything's a new experience.
Take your time, enjoy it while it lasts. And if something is bothering you or there's something that seems like it's just not going right, just know it probably doesn't matter that much or at all in the long run. So just, yep, have fun, enjoy it, and make the most of it.
Focusing on exploring, because I think doing what you want is most important, just expanding what you're interested in so that you can find what interests you and find what suits you better, and you can improve yourself that way. So that's something that I've been told multiple times when I was younger. Just focus on exploring and gaining the experience, and I think that has helped me really be happy as I look back at my senior year. So
it's never too late to try something.
Thank you so much, seniors, for everything you've contributed to our school these past 4 years. And on behalf of Spark Shorts, I wish you all a wonderful graduation. This is Caroline Jaw signing off of Spark Shorts until next year.
Welcome to another, and might I add, the final word of the week. Yeah, it's the last one. It's a little heartbreaking, I know, but we can get through it. So this week's word is, I forgot to pick a word. Oh, we go ask some teachers. See if they have any ideas.
I like the word defenestrate. My husband taught it to me. I also like it because we see the French origins of the word used in English. It's a really good one. Look
That's
it up if you don't know
cool.
it.
Thank you, Mom.
Okay, Mr. Touche, what is your favorite word and why?
Parsimonious is my favorite word, all right? It's a long, complex term, but it really means something nice, short, and concise.
Okay, it sounds like parsley.
Okay, I have permission from Audra to go
yes,
in the opposite
do.
Direction
And it's not maybe a word, but a phrase that I don't like, and it's spontaneous combustion. Because nothing is just gonna blow up in flames without some kind of a spark or activation energy, right?
That's very true.
Very yes, true. I agree. Don't like the term spontaneous combustion. Never, ever.
All right, well, thank you. All right, Ms. Brusto, what is your favorite word and why?
I have two favorite words. The first is sinusoidal. And I think it speaks for itself because it's beautiful to say. And anything that has sinusoidal characteristics is inherently beautiful.
Yes, absolutely.
My other favorite word is crop, like a farmer's crop.
Interesting.
I think it sounds refreshing and delicious, and I've always liked it.
I would disagree, but all right.
Sounds like crap.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Yep.
Crop does not sound refreshing.
All right, just got back. Ignore the fact that I'm wearing the same clothes as the beginning and different ones than I was in school. It's irrelevant. Anyway. Lots of cool words, except crop, maybe. But I think all in all, through that and through this entire year of Word of the Week, I think we've learned that there's a lot of pretty cool words out there. Hopefully I have exposed you to some more of them, because who doesn't want to obfuscate all the time? But anyway, that is it for Word of the Week this year. This is it for Spark Shorts this year. So thank you so much for watching, and have a nice summer. Bye!